All right, good morning, folks. I'm at Oceanside Transit Center and got a lot of shuttles that are filling up here. I saw a couple buses come by as I was driving through, and yeah, so it's kind of a little bit of a waiting game to get on a shuttle. It's still a roughly, I would say, 10-minute walk from where the buses drop us off to transition, so it's gonna be a pretty expedient transition today. And but I usually only need about 10 minutes in transition, so just gonna get in and get out and keep the ball rolling, basically. So given that, I might just switch out to my running shoes and have my other shoes into the car now, given that it's gonna be a couple of minutes. So yeah, we're just gonna go and get ready here, although at the same time I've also got my sandals in the car as well, so I just wear my sandals after the race. So we're in downtown Oceanside here. It's where the transit center is located, and there have been buses that have been coming along, but I'll talk to you more when I get to transition and once I wake up a little bit more, although the caffeine's already starting to flow in me. Till then, talk to you in a bit. Morning, folks. It's just short of 6 a.m. here in transition. A little dark from the GoPro camera. And made it just about 20 minutes to spare here. I'm only gonna need about 10 to 15 minutes in transition because I expect to go in and out. And going into the crowded area here. Let me see if I can get
to
my pros to see if Kayla is here. Let's see. Where's Kayla? Is she here? I'm gonna bug her. But nope. This is Kayla's bike. I'm gonna bug her when she gets back around here. And aside from that, I gotta get into transition shortly. And then I'm gonna keep it rolling here and keep it moving. So, yep, Kayla's one of the local pros, at least I know very well. So if I recall, the even numbers have me rack on the far side here. Oh, now I gotta actually make it, see how the bike has fared here. Bikes have made it. 202, the Argon 18 buddies. All right. So I now made it to the right. Yeah, side by side. So I got to figure out which one's the real one, right?
Perfect.
Of course, mine's the real one.
Booties are allowed if you choose to do so.
Now, got to quickly go and set up.
Don't worry about it. We've got extra time to tip for you at the swim start.
I've got to do quick transition here, so I gotta cut this video a little bit short.
We will give you an opportunity to do a little warm-up.
As soon as I get transition set up, then I'll go ahead and get rolling. So until then, we'll go with the snap of the finger.
The guy in transition, the Godfather, get you out of here.
Set up here
by 6:30.
It's a little dark to see, but let me get out of the way. There we go. The towel's on top. Then we have to wear the race bib number when you're on the bike due to Camp Pendleton rules.
An athlete that forgot their helmet.
Wow.
If you could bring it up to the black tent at the check-in,
so,
right where you walked in.
People are heading over to the swim.
Hopefully get an athlete a helmet.
I am as well.
If we have an extra one.
It's going to be a nice day. 66, 67 for the high. And yeah. So we'll get ready here, and unfortunately you won't be seeing me filming on course because, well, that's Ironman rules, and it's a little bit of a hassle to try to carry a camera through on race day. But aside from that, and also military rules as well, so Now that I've got transition set up, I'm about to say goodbye to a couple of my things here, unfortunately. But I'll be back in several hours. Go ahead. No worries. And all the pros have already started making their way over to swim start. And I am as well. So till then, I'll see you after the race. You'll probably see race finisher photos. Probably, I'll post a video once I get the race finisher photo.
Right. So great that's probably one of the videos
you
as
well.
Are doing fantastic. And it's going to be a great day.
Yeah. So we're going here and talk to you guys when I finish the race and give you my recap and thoughts.
But the sun will come up in just a few minutes.
And but the thought here
right
is
6:40 with our male pros.
The swim is, I'm going to go with my swim at the 70.3 pace that I did at Washington, 70.3 from the field. It may be a few minutes slower, but hey, that's the fact with Ocean Swim. The water is really calm here for the swim exit, so that's why I'll start accelerating. Bike, I'm going to be going at a zone 3 power instead of my upper zone 2. This is an experimental race for me, so I'll be more or less going at Z3, low mid Z3, so I'm going to increase wattage by about 15 to 20 watts, and then also increase my nutrition intake as a result, probably every 25 to 30 minutes instead of every 30 to 35.
It's time to go. We are going to do this.
Run and going to maintain the same run pace. So there we go. That's pretty straightforward race plan for me. But the experiment is increasing the bike power to see what'll happen to me, and hopefully
lots
I don't blow up. So I was able to do 2.5 hours of really hard tempo on a really flat course. I don't think I'm gonna do 2.5 hours for this because it's 2,700 feet of gain. I'm more out there just to have fun, and if anything under 5 hours would be amazing. But if not, I'm not gonna disappoint myself because again, this is an experimental race for me. So I expect transitions to be relatively quick. Especially because now I'm going to have the bib number on me. So, until then, catch with you guys once I am back here, probably in about 6.5 hours or so. So, until then, catch you later. Right. I originally intended to record this a little bit earlier today, but I decided, well, one, I've got a couple of bandages around me. Yeah, I unfortunately had a little minor tussle, aka with a bike, a small minor bike crash right at around mile 22. And that was more than the course. That was me losing concentration because I was going out a little bit harder than I normally do in terms of just experimenting. And the overall sentiment that I had for this race was to go out there, have fun, and just put up a number and see where that lands me. And also racing alongside with the professionals, at least in some parts of the course, knowing that I was fast enough so that I wouldn't get lapped while I was at the run, but secondly also is to also see some of the pros in action was really cool to see, even if they were an hour and a half ahead of me, which by no means, I mean, yeah, that's just the reality of the situation as well. But to recap on the race here, I would say that it was kind of a tale of two stories. The morning, early part of the morning was kind of, I guess, it definitely didn't feel like it was going to be a great effort. And really kind of what set the tone for that is when the swim started, that first 200 meters to get out to the open ocean, yeah, there were some pretty big waves out there. And yeah, I was slammed a couple times, and that was a bit of a struggle, and it felt like I couldn't go anywhere. And yeah, those swells were pretty gnarly, I have to say. When they're, this isn't like, yeah, this is, it was closer to like 4 feet, not 2 to 3. So that made for a very interesting experience. And it was funny because I was laughing at the pros and they were trying to get through it. And then it's like, well, wait a minute, I've also got to go through this. So I ate my own, well, I drank my own Kool-Aid, AKA a lot of salt water. And that wasn't very fun. So the first 5 minutes literally for me was just trying to navigate through the chaos and essentially kind of survive that first 200 meters to get to that first swim pool buoy. And then finally was able to settle into a rhythm roughly about 8 minutes in. But yeah, there was first 200 meters was definitely rough, and it equated to me, I think the time officially was like 32 minutes for the swim, which by my standards was not a great swim. And I kind of felt a little bit, part of it was because of that chop, but also I just couldn't really get into any sort of a good rhythm. And I think part of it is that I haven't really practiced with a full sleeve wetsuit, which was definitely necessary for the water temperatures here. But normally when I go sleeveless, I have a little bit more freedom with that. So so that was essentially the swim. So the swim was a little bit over 32 minutes, which again, like I said, is not my best swim that I've had. Then going into transition, I took my time in transition, so I won't really talk about transitions much, but basically, I take my time through these transitions, both in T1 and T2. So there wasn't really anything exciting. Now, that's something that I will definitely work on for next year. I want to definitely be faster, because race conditions were kind of ideal for a good transition time here. But I was about 6 minutes in both transitions, which in my perspective, I really wasn't focusing on that, but that is an area where I could, if I cut those transitions in half, then I'm adding 6 minutes. I'm basically taking off 6 minutes of time, which is absolutely valuable. So that's something that I definitely need to work on. But that was not a focus for this race. Then going into the bike, I was trying to push roughly at 0.8 intensity factor, which is roughly about 245-250 watts. I was able to do that for the first hour, roughly first hour before that bike crash. And then came the hill, as I'm looking at my computer here, then came the hill, which is right along San Mateo Drive. And yeah, that was a killer hill. I had a 1125 cassette on my back, and for lack of a better term, that was absolutely brutal, knowing that I really needed like an 1130 or 1132. And unfortunately, my DI2 wouldn't take anything beyond an 1130, and there was none floating around anywhere because, of course, there are no bike parts anywhere that you can find. So yeah, that bike climb, I had to push VO2 max power, which was not fun at 55 RPM. Going up 12% for a half a mile was absolute torture. But once I got through that, then there were a couple of other punch climbs of 8-9% along the way. And yeah, those weren't very pretty either. I was definitely having to push some more wattage than I was hoping for. And so that kind of, I tried not to burn a match, but I felt like I burned one, of course, going up 12%, but I think everybody was going to. And I was struggling a little bit with power output at the end of the bike. But even with the crash and yes, a few bandages here and there, I would say the bike performance overall was pretty good.
averaging 233, which was a little under which I was hoping for, but the normalized power was 250, which told me that I was going a little bit harder and purposely a little harder. And that was a solid bike, considering what I put myself through. I put myself in a bad situation, and that's more on me in terms of that crash. And now I'm going to have to deal with the after effects of it. But the flat sections were pretty good. I was able to put out hard power. There's lessons learned to where this is basically a limiter for me, where I was training a lot of Z2, and it was hard for me to get into tempo, which was more or less what I was trying to do, similar to my tempo workout for Ironman California. That happened the week before. So I was trying to replicate that, but I was able to replicate it for the first hour, but the rest of the bike, not so much, but also hill climbs. What can you do? But again, an area of opportunity for me. And it's kind of, this race is kind of, if there's any summary for this race makes me love, it makes me realize I want more from triathlon. And then we'll go into the run just a bit here. Got to swap out the battery. All right, I've changed the battery here, so apologies for that. But where I left off is the bike was overall right around 2 hours and 34 minutes, which I thought was a solid bike considering quite a bit of elevation gain in terms of how steep the elevation gain is. Because you can have a lot of elevation gain, but having it come with really, really small hills is one thing. But here, this elevation gain was big, big climb. So there was going to be some slowdown in terms of overall times. And actually, this bike was probably my best in terms of overall standings from a performance standpoint. So pretty happy about the bike, even after that little bit of an incident. But now let's go to the run. And I was kind of surprised how good I felt going out. I knew that I was coming out of transition hot. I was running just at around 7-minute mile pace, which I was like, I know this is not sustainable, or at least I don't think this is sustainable for a long time. So as soon as I realized, oh, wait a minute, that first mile went by 7-minute pace, I knew right away, okay, I needed to back off a little bit. But a part of that is because the course is kind of downhill, going to the beach side, which is cool. And I got into a groove. It took about 1.5 miles to get into a groove because my feet were still somewhat cold for some reason. I think it was because I was splashing water on my knee from the crash, so I was trying to keep it clean. And so, and aside from that, I had what I thought was a solid run. There were some parts, especially along going up the really steep inclines up to the other street level, and between the lower and the higher street level, those were just steep inclines, and that's like short punch inclines where the first time I went through, I kind of shuffled my way up. The second time I was like, nope, I'm walking this. There was no way I was going to try to climb up such a steep incline. At least that wasn't part of my strategy. So, but all the straight sections were, yeah, I was putting down the gas where I could on the straight sections. And then there was some undulation, so some of these kind of rolling hills, I mean, they weren't really hills, but they were just some inclines where you had to think about it a little bit. Some of these were pretty steep and some were a little less steep, but they kind of varied all throughout. And so it proved to be a little bit of a challenge, but nothing that wasn't manageable. And I felt I managed those pretty well. Although there were some times where I was probably going a little bit slower, and I think part of it was due to fatigue. And now I realize that I can, yeah, it's late at night for me here, 10 p.m. as I'm recording this. But looking back at this a little bit further now, I think I could have gone a little bit harder on those upper hills without really sacrificing much. But I think part of it is that was not the type of training that I was doing. And I was incorporating some hill reps, so I was able to get through a couple of them without too much of an issue. But as, of course, the day went on, as I started to get into the second loop of the run, I knew that my fitness was not there to be able to really push as hard as I wanted to. I mean, I'm coming in roughly 20 CTL less than where I was at my peak for Oregon. So I knew coming in, I was not in the best race shape, but I knew I was going to at least perform relatively well. And the run turned out better than expected, to be honest. But I knew I was kind of gunning for it a little bit because I wanted to, I secretly had in mind that I wanted to finish right before 12. And spoiler, yeah, I finished before 12 p.m. with 20 seconds to go. So that was kind of my interior motive goal, is finish before noon and you'll be very happy. And finishing before noon meant that I was, I wouldn't say guaranteed, but just about a sub 5 hour pace. So super happy with that. But overall with the run, I've got to figure out what's going on with my shoes, because I keep getting left foot pain from my Carbon X2s for some reason. My other pair of Carbon X2s never had that issue. So I'm kind of curious as to what's going on there. And I'm going to be doing a lot of things in the offseason to try different types of pairs to see what kind of... I'm really looking forward to the On Clouds, but I'll talk about more about what things I'm looking for in the offseason in a separate video from this, as I'm already going on really long here. It's probably, what, 13 minutes of recording by now? But overall performance, 4 hours and 56 minutes and some change, and I would say of all my performances, this, of course, wasn't my best performance, but this was a really good, this was a solid performance given where I am with my fitness. And given that I was kind of going in a little bit of a downtrend in terms of overall fitness shape coming off from my peak from a few months ago. So in short, the race went fairly well. I didn't really have much of a plan going in other than go at the certain types of feel for when it comes to the swim, bike, and the run. And if there's anything that this race taught me, is that I really love this sport of triathlon. I will admit, I ended the run having some energy still left. So that shows too that there are places where I could definitely push a little bit more, because I feel that at the end of these 70.3 races, I should feel broken, but I didn't feel broken at the end of this race. So I think part of it was fitness, but also part of it was race strategy, which I think I can definitely be more aggressive, which moving forward, that's going to be a lesson that's going to be learned for future races. Aside from that, yeah, that's basically a recap of my thoughts on Oceanside 70.3. Great venue, great course. I'm thinking about, next year, I need a 70.3 race before Ironman Frankfurt. Maybe this might be it instead of Victoria. Okay? So, for now, I'm going to check out. I definitely need to clean up the rest of it here. I did already clean up some kit. I already did laundry, so now the rest is just to heal up and get ready to go into the off season, which I'll be posting another video. Toasting. I need that for. I could use some wine after this race, but looking forward to this off season. Really, I have a lot of motivation going into this off season for where I want to work on. And this race kind of exposed some of the places of opportunity. And I'm going to try to take full advantage of that. And that's my thoughts going in. and talk to you guys later. And of course, if you like any of this content, then of course hit that subscribe button for me or click the bell notification to get the latest and greatest of videos when I do post them. I'm a little bit backlogged at the moment. I've been very focused in on getting these videos uploaded. And tomorrow I'll be in San Diego to really explore the LA area and, well, not LA, explore San Diego, which is a city I've never been to. And also just have more fun since I really haven't had time off. And I'm really kind of taking this time to really just decouple away from real life work. And now that I'm done with races, and also decouple away from triathlon for a few days. Although I really kind of am like, I want to do another 70.3 right now. But I know that what's best for me right now is I do need the mental break, because it can be very stressful at times. And the race season kind of wore on me as I had 3 big races in 5 weeks. So I'm looking forward to this off season. And yeah. So if I haven't already said already, click subscribe, hit the bell, leave a comment down below, and of course hit the like button if you like this video. So until then, I'll talk to you guys later.